The extent of the hypokagenic areas has decreased in the right lobe as did the hypokagenic field in the upper part of the left lobe. The change over 3 months is consistent with the usual course of de Quervain's thyroiditis, as is the persistence of hypokagenic areas. The echonormal nodule remained unchanged.